Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be playing a game that is very close to my heart. A game that is not very well known whatsoever, and that game is called Pieces. This game is basically a game that you solve jigsaw puzzles faster than your opponent. It sounds boring in a way, but trust me, it's not whatsoever. It's actually a very interesting game, and I used to play this game religiously when I was a kid, all the time, because I loved puzzles and stuff like that. Yes, it is a very, very weird looking game, but don't worry, it'll all make sense to you in just a second. One player versus computer. And yeah, I'll start with easy, because if you go to the higher levels, you won't have... you'll miss the earlier levels like this one with Rice Bowl Crab here. Oh no, he's a very accurate crab. Well, actually, it looks like a she, because it's got some very long eyelashes there. So yeah, the puzzle's starting. We got a nice a jet fighter here, excuse me. I have a little bit of allergy problems lately here, so I've been clearing my throat a lot more than usual, which isn't all that surprising since it is spring after all. So yeah, we're just putting together a jigsaw puzzle. You'll see these items that are appearing along the left side there. You can use those to hurt your opponent or slow them down or whatever. Like this one here, this is actually for you. If you click that one, you will make three spotlights appear on the screen where those top three pieces, where they go, but you have to figure out where they go. It's a thing of, it just hints you where those three go. And the next, the one below that is, crosses out two pieces of your opponent's side, so they can only use, one piece at a time, so they always have to pick and choose. The next one below is to slow your opponent down, your opponent's cursor down, excuse me. The next one is a mirror to reflect attacks directed towards you. Auto lets you place your pieces automatically by just clicking on them. They'll move to their correct spots. The next one is a reverse control for your opponent. It reverses their controls. But this last one summons forth a little puzzle piece to help you place pieces. And I accidentally took his piece away from him, but that's okay. Yeah, so basically all those items are either to slow your opponent down or to make you finish your side faster. It's a really great concept, and I really wanted to see a sequel to this game as a kid, but it just never happened. I guess it just didn't gain enough popularity, but it's a great puzzle game concept. Here's some new stuff here. This is a radar. What that does is if you click on it, it gives you a little radar around your pointer there, and it'll direct you to where the piece goes, you know, correctly. When you land on the correct spot, it'll spin. Like, I'll show you that in just a second there. Next one down below is a silhouette. What the silhouette does is it gives you a silhouette of the picture, so it'll allow you to place pieces a lot easier, because it'll give you an idea of what the picture looks like in case you forgot. The next one down, the fifth one from the top is the syringe, which drains your opponent's items down to nothing, and the final one down there is called the sweeper. This one's awesome. It sweeps away your opponent's pieces. It sweeps away every other space, so that really slows down the opponent. I'm gonna show you the rest of the items as I go, but for now, I'm just gonna continue putting together this puzzle here, and hopefully won't lose. Nah, I'm not gonna lose whatsoever. That crab guy is really slow, and because I'm already done. Yay! I am a happy little puzzler. Whoa! It just had some sound problems there. I guess the emulation for this game isn't quite perfect, but that's alright. It'll be just fine. Anyway, hold on for just a second. Back with more epic puzzle-solving action. This is the Delinquent Boar. Oh no! I have to face a pig on a scooter! It doesn't really look like much of a motorcycle, but it looks more like a scooter. So yeah, I think it's a scooter. So he's not really that much of a baddie double S pig there. And so we got a whale puzzle here. And, shoot! That was a corner piece and I missed twice! That was just full of fail all over the place. I think that one goes there. That's another interesting thing about this game is that you always have only three pieces to pick from in the one-player mode here, so you've got to memorize the picture before you start playing the game, before you start playing each puzzle, or putting together each puzzle altogether, because otherwise you'll have a lot harder time placing the pieces or finding out where they go. And that was just full of fail right there, because I just noticed that one went in the upper space, but that's okay. This is still the early game. The early game is very easy, but the puzzles do repeat themselves. Like, there's a limited amount of puzzles in the game that you can have. By the way, the pig there just used the radar, so see that little arrow around his cursor? And I just failed with that piece again, dang it! You can see it directs him to the correct spot where his pieces go. But if you don't really know where the piece is going to begin with, it's still gonna be just as slow as placing the piece manually. In fact, you're better off just skipping through pieces. If you can't correctly, or you can't find the place that a piece needs to go, because it, see that thing at the bottom, that POW meter? For every time it fills, you get one of those items off to the left side, and when it all fills up, and you get all these awesome items, like that little puzzle piece there that is helping me demolish my opponent in puzzle-solving speed, and I just made a mistake there. Whoopsie-doodle. And that just is what happens on this game, unless you've got all these puzzles memorized by heart. And next one, oh, I got auto. I can show you how the auto works now. I'll just click on the auto, and then I'll click on a piece. It automatically moves into place. Isn't that convenient? It's also very fast. It also charges up slower than if you were to place a piece normally, but that's to be expected because that is a sort of cheating item, so to speak. So you only get about half the power that you would by placing the piece normally. So yeah, we got some skier person here now, and oh no, he slowed me down. No, let me move. Let me move. I must move. Must put together puzzle. Must sweep. Oh, actually, maybe I should have reversed his controls. That would have been more effective because he doesn't have very many pieces solved on his puzzle there. So, oh no! He slowed me down right before I was going to place the piece, and it threw me off, and I missed. And let's try this out. That's what that thing does. It blocks out the pieces, and yeah. The computers are stupid, and they go to the other pieces, so that just goes to show how bad the AI is in this game. And wow, is that going to glitch the sound every time I get there? Well, whatever. I guess that's it for this part. I'll see you guys in the next part. Woo!